Hey guys, so if you are new to my channel, my name is Natalie, and today I'm going to be sharing with you my March beauty favorites. So let's just get started. I have a lot of products this month that were favorites for hair products. So the first product I'm going to share is this leave-in conditioner from the brand Andalou Naturals. I think I already talked about this in a previous video. I think it was a video where I talked about how I style my hair when I leave it curly. I've just really been liking this still for the month March. I've been using this basically nonstop every time I wash my hair. So this is just an leave-in conditioner and it's their moisture-rich formula. And it has argan oil in it. It says it smooths, nourishes, detangles, and fights frizz for softness and shine. I really like using this. It really helps to just moisturize my hair when it's wet. Basically, every time I wash my hair, I will apply this after when I get out of the shower, and I will just brush it through my hair. And it really helps to detangle my hair and moisturize it, and just to really help it to feel softer because my hair gets really tangled and dry. So this is really helpful, and it smells really good. And then my next product is also a hair product. It is from the brand Aveda. I think I talked about this as well. This is from their Smooth Infusion line, and it is their Nourishing Styling Cream. It nourishes and controls frizz for an all-day smooth style. I love using this product because you could either let your hair dry naturally when you're using it, or you can use heat with it. It works both ways. On the back of the bottle, it actually says to apply thoroughly to towel-dried hair and then blow-dry or air-dry and style as desired. It really helps to fight frizz and just helps to define my curls. This is what my hair looks like naturally. It's basically dry, maybe a little bit damp still, but basically dry. So this product just works really well to fight frizz and help define my curls. It doesn't make my curls super like bouncy, but it does help define them. And then the last hair styling product is also from Aveda, and I talked about this in a previous video as well, but it is the Smooth Infusion Naturally Straight. It progressively loosens curls for a straight style. Unlike the Smooth Infusion Nourishing Styling Cream, this Naturally Straight product is designed to be used with heat. So on the bottle, it just says to apply the cream in sections to towel-dried hair, and then to blow dry and flat iron if needed. But I still do use this a lot of times in combination with this, even if I'm gonna let my hair air dry, because I may let my hair air dry one day and let it be curly or wavy, and then either that night or the next morning, rather than washing my hair again, I'll straighten my hair. So then this will actually help to keep it straight and hold the straight style longer. But if you are just looking for something that is going to help define your curls when they dry naturally, I wouldn't say that you necessarily need this product, but I like using this in conjunction with this just because it really helps to prep my hair for either a curly or straight style. The last two hair products are shampoos and conditioners, and they are from the brand, I'm not sure how you pronounce this, but it looks like it's either Ouidad or Weedad or Weedad. I'm not sure. This is what the actual bottle looks like in the spelling. I'll link the product down below. But I use the Play Curl Curl Amplifying Shampoo and the Play Curl Curl Amplifying Conditioner. I discovered this brand from Ulta. Sometimes at Ulta, when you make an online purchase, they have a little promotion going on where you get a makeup bag that has some samples inside. And one of the samples in the bag that I got a couple months ago was from this brand, but it was not the same exact product. It was a shampoo, but I forgot what it was, but it was a different shampoo. I think it was a clarifying shampoo. I can't remember, but I tried it out and I actually ended up really liking it. I just really loved the smell and I loved how it made my hair feel, and it suds it up really well in the shower. And then I went on Ulta's website and I looked at the different products from this brand, and I decided to go with this one, the Play Curl line, because this one is designed for loose curls and I do not have very tight curls, as you could see. My hair is kind of in between wavy and curly, so I thought that this would be perfect for it because it's supposed to plump from within for a curl optimizing body, and the conditioner is supposed to give you body and fullness without the unwanted weight. After using these products for the past month, I've been using it all through March. I love these. These are my new favorite shampoos and conditioners. I have definitely noticed a difference in my hair since I've been using these. My hair feels so much softer, smoother. It is less tangled. It's easier to brush out when I get out of the shower. And the curls, my curls look so much more defined and less frizzy. Before I used this product, I didn't really have a shampoo or conditioner that really made a difference in my hair as far as the curls go. I would only notice a difference in how my hair is dried when I use different styling products, but I definitely notice difference after using the shampoo and conditioner. It really helps my curls to just look more polished and smooth and defined and really cuts down on the frizz. So I really like these. They do not weigh down my hair at all. They have a really clean, like natural scent. The smell of Aveda products is more kind of like natural herbal, I would say, but this one smells natural but less herbal, I guess. But I really like how it smells. It smells so good. My next two favorites are actually brushes. This one is from the brand Crown Brush, and it is their SS023 Jumbo Kabuki Fan Brush. I got this in my BoxyCharm for March. I have really been liking using this to bronze and contour my face. It just really makes it super easy to get into the hollows of your cheeks and also to reach like the top of your forehead if you want to contour there as well. And it's really soft. I just really like this brush. And then my other favorite brush for this month is a Sedona lace brush. It is their EB17 brush. So it is just a typical eyebrow brush. It has an angled side on one end, and then on the other side it has a spoolie. I really like this brush to do my brows with powder products. I've actually been reaching for it more than my Anastasia Beverly Hills eyebrow brush, which I actually really do like this one, but since I got this, I think I got this in my BoxyCharm from February, I've been reaching for this one more. For some reason, I just like how it applies product better. Maybe because it's a little bit taller, so it's easier to work with. I don't know if that is what the difference is. I don't know. I really like this. I'll show you what the brushes look like just to compare them. So the one on the right is the Sedona lace brush, and the one on the left is the Anastasia brush. And then again, the one on the right is the Sedona lace brush, and the one on the left is the Anastasia brush. So the actual angled brush side, they look pretty similar, but on the spoolie side, the Sedona lace brush is larger. It's a little bit longer. So I'm not sure exactly what it is about this brush. It might be the spoolie. I'm not sure if it's the angled side or the spoolie, but I really like this brush. Okay, my next favorite is also related to my brows. It is an eyeshadow, and it is from the brand Smashbox. It is their eyeshadow trio. This specific trio is called Filter, but it has the shades Vanilla, Sumatra, and Sable. But I actually use these eyeshadows for my brows. I mix the two brown shades and use those as brow powders, and then I use the ivory kind of white shade as a brow bone highlight, and also to just kind of clean up my brows because it is a little bit lighter than my skin tone, but it just helps to kind of clean up any of the brow powder that gets in the way. I really like the consistency of this eyeshadow. I think it works really well for my brows. So yeah, this is a good one for brows. If you have a similar hair color or a brow color or anything, I would suggest looking into this because this works a lot better than any other brow powders I've used. I've tried the Anastasia brow powder. I've tried, I think, some brow powders from NYX Cosmetics, from e.l.f. Cosmetics. I can't remember other brands off the top of my head, but I've tried out a lot of different brow products and brow powders. It's like not too pigmented, but it's pigmented enough where it will give you enough color to fill in your brows. And the consistency, I think, is the most important part because it's like the perfect formula of powder where it sticks to your brows and it gives it like a texture, but it doesn't like have a lot of fallout, and it's I don't know how to explain it. It just works really well for brows. So if you are looking for a brow powder, I would suggest looking into Smashbox eyeshadows for using as brow powders. Okay, my next favorite for March is the Best Damn Beauty Lip Mask, and this is the brand from Nicole Guerrero. If you've never heard of it, but I'm sure you have, if you're watching beauty videos, you've probably seen Nicole Guerrero's videos before. I really like this. It works really well to moisturize and hydrate your lips, especially before you're going to go in with lipsticks or even a matte lipstick. I like this better than all my other chapsticks or lip balms. It's way more moisturizing and not sticky or oily or greasy. It smells really good. It kind of has a floral scent, and then you get a lot of product in the little jar. It's just a little pink cream lip balm, but I love this. If you're looking for a good lip mask or good lip balm, I would suggest this. Okay, my next favorite is a fragrance. This is not a full size. This is a little like deluxe size I got from Sephora, but it is the Stella McCartney Pop perfume. I don't know if it's a perfume or an eau de parfum or whatever, but it's their fragrance. It's the Pop fragrance from Stella McCartney, and I got this from Sephora. I actually like keep a lot of fragrance. Let me show you. Okay, so these are all of the perfumes. These are all of the perfume samples that I have received from Ulta and Sephora. I kind of just collect them. I think it's nice to have a lot of different fragrances. just to be able to smell them, because if I want to get into a new fragrance, I could smell the little tester and then I know whether or not I actually like it without having to go to the store. Because when I go to the actual store to smell all the different perfumes, I get a headache or I forget what the perfumes smell like because all of the scents kind of get mixed together. So I don't know, I like having all these little minis. But anyway, out of all of these, my favorite by far is the Stella McCartney Pop fragrance. It just smells really clean and fresh, a tiny bit sweet. It doesn't have like a strong floral or fruity scent to it. It just smells really clean and fresh. I'm not sure how to explain it. If you've never smelled this, I would really recommend that you go to Sephora and go smell the tester or wherever else they sell it. I don't think they sell it at Ulta, but I know they sell it at Sephora because that's where I got it. But when I run out of this, I'm probably going to get the full size because it just smells so good. Okay, my next favorite is an eyeliner from Maybelline. It is the Line Stiletto Liquid Eyeliner in the shade Brownish Black. I used to use this. This was my go-to liquid liner. I used to use it in just the plain black shade. I used this for years. I feel like this is the only liquid liner I used for the past couple years before I started trying out new ones. But for some reason, I stopped using this a few months ago, and I started using like the NYX one and the ICO liquid liner, and then those started getting a little bit old, dried up. So I went back to this one and actually really like it. I forgot how easy it is to line your eyes with this. So that's what I have on my eyes right now. Even though it is in the shade Brownish Black, it's not too brown. It's pretty dark for a brownish black shade. I also like this in their black shade. It's a felt tip liner, so it just looks like this. And then I could swatch it real quick with my, this is my left hand moving, so it's probably not gonna be that good. So that was like a thick line. That's a thin line, obviously. The formula of this liquid liner and the actual applicator make it really easy to line your eyes and give a winged liner. Especially if you don't have experience with using liquid liners and you want to start trying them out, or if you want to especially do a winged liner, I would suggest maybe giving this one a try because the applicator makes it a lot easier to do a winged liner in comparison to like a brush applicator, which is a lot more difficult. You get a more precise line with the brush applicator, but this one works just fine for me and it is a lot easier to use. Okay, my last two products for March are both from Too Faced. They are lip products. So this is a little mini. I got this from Ulta or Sephora or Too Faced, I can't remember. Is when I ordered something online. I think I got it from Too Faced as like a little sample with my order, but it is their La Creme lipstick and it is in the shade Naked Dolly. I think this little package, even though it's tiny, it's so cute. It's the pretty gold packaging. Too Faced just makes their packaging so cute. It's a really pretty pink nude shade. So this is what the shade looks like swatched on my hand. It's just a really pretty kind of peachy pink nude, and I actually have this on my lips right now. When I was swatching it, I think I pushed too hard because it kind of crumbled on the end. I really like this color. It's a really pretty everyday peachy nude. And the formula is really creamy and hydrating, and it makes it really easy to apply. The only thing is, when I'm applying it, I notice that it is a little bit patchy. Like when you keep going over, you kind of see through it. Once I go over a few times, it has pretty good pigmentation and coverage. And then my other favorite from Too Faced is their Sweet Peach Creamy Peach Oil Lip Gloss, and I have the shade Peach Fuzz. I really like this. I wasn't sure if I was gonna like this at first when I saw it advertised from Too Faced. Just because I don't like lip glosses that much. I do like lip glosses, but they're not my favorite. I don't like it when they're sticky. And like, I hate it when I'm wearing a lip gloss and it's windy outside and my hair blows into my face and then it sticks to my lips. That just really grosses me out and I don't like it. But anyway, I do actually really like this lip gloss. So right here is the lip gloss. It's very similar in color to the lipstick right here, but it's a lot more sheer because it's a gloss. It's just a really pretty peach nude gloss, and I love the formula. I have this on my lips as well, on top of the lipstick, and I love the smell of this. It smells so good. It smells like peach candy, kind of. It smells so good, and it tastes good too. Like if you get some on your tongue or if you lick your lips, it tastes good. Not saying that you should eat it, but it does taste good when you get it on your tongue. I do really like this lip gloss. This is probably my favorite lip gloss that I own right now, just because I love the color. It has good pigmentation for a gloss, and it's not sticky. It feels hydrating because it's an oil lip gloss, but it's not sticky. I hate sticky lip glosses, and this is not sticky. So that completes my beauty favorites for the month of March. I know a lot of products in my favorites this month were hair products, but I finally kind of feel like I'm figuring out what products work for my hair to let it dry naturally and curly without using any heat on it. I do like straightening my hair as well, but I like to alternate between letting it dry naturally and then using heat because I want to protect my hair and minimize the heat damage because when I was in high school, I used to straighten my hair every single day. I would wash my hair every day and straighten it every day. And my hair was so damaged and like fried, and it was really hard to grow my hair out. So I think my hair is looking a lot healthier now than it used to, even though I do color my hair now. You can't see the bottom, but my hair goes down to this long, if that makes sense. You can see. Now, when I actually straighten my hair, it's even longer because when it's curled, it goes up a little bit. It like shrinks up a little bit. But yeah, I hope you enjoyed watching this video. Let me know in the comments if you've tried out any of these products, and if you are interested in any of these products, let me know what you think if you try them out. I hope this favorites video kind of helps you to figure out what products might work for you. I hope you liked watching this video. Please subscribe if you haven't already so that you could keep up with my future videos. I hope you have a wonderful day, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye!